Okay, here we are back in the shed, and the next thing to do on the GT380 is the front mudguard, which is there. Now that is a universal mudguard. The price, people are asking for a rusty old bits of rubbish, original ones, is just ridiculous. So I'm just going to fit one of these, as you can see, and no holes there. So what I'm going to have to try and do is first of all see where that's going to sit, where that looks right on there on the bike, and then I'll have to try and make some sort of template up for those, for the fixing holes, or measure them, do it that way. But one way or the other, gonna have to end up with some holes in there. So that is the next thing to do. I'll just go for a little bit of a test fit, see how it looks, and see mainly what height that needs to be on there. Is good for it. The rubber gaiters are tight. Squeeze that in a bit. So let's get that so it looks at the right kind of height. And the right sort of position. I want it low or high. The only trouble is, have it too low, these, unless I trim them off, then the chrome seems like get a bit of rust coming in there. Don't want them too low, because that will just look rough. So possibly somewhere around there. It's a case of doing this by height, really. Right, looks like the middle of that one is there. Middle of that one is there. They are slightly wrong, could always slot them, give a little bit of adjustment. I think we'll try and get that out without smudging those marks now. Okay, measure those before they disappear. Okay, so got a measurement. So it's 40, camera, 40 millimetre from the bottom edge to the centre line of the holes I need to drill. So that bit sorted. Now I just need to somehow measure the gap between the bolts. Which is a little bit difficult unless I take the wheel out. I don't really want to do. Put my glasses on. Might be able to see what I'm doing then. Yeah. let's see what we've got there, 63.3. I don't tend to put things at odd sizes. If the other way, if I get a couple of bolts in, he's got shoulders, yes they have. Put the bolts in like that. And measure across the shoulders. So what I'm doing is measuring across the two shoulders of those bolts. Okay, with the vernier 69.2. If I take one of these bolts out, measure the diameter of that shoulder. Is 7 mil. So if we take 7 off 69, we'll say a 62 between centers. So 40 up 62 between centers. Write that down and forget. Okay, so that'll be the next thing, is to drill some holes in here. So I've just got a couple of lines I've just scribed in with the verniers, and I'm just going to put a centre punch in. Probably not the best thing, a centre punch on, but that's all I've got to do this. Not really solid enough to send the punch in, but right. So now I'm probably going to have to put this on a block, I think, or the top of this vise, just to raise it up enough to get that in the center. Yeah, a little bit precarious. Try that a bit. And center drill. Go in with a 7 and then just open that out a bit. Still get there and that, yep, I'll do fine. Okay, it. So I thought it was going to. Scent drill to take the burrs off. Side of them, run it far across. Just to take the burrs out. There we are, holes drilled. The sides deburred. And the moment of truth, see if they'll actually fit. Take these bolts out again. Bolt's bigger than you think. The thread is bigger than the shoulder, so we'll need to do them to 8mm, which is what he was going to do. Okay, so these bolts that hold on to that shoulder there is 7mm, the actual thread is 8mm. So I've just now re-drilled these 8.5, so I will go through there with a little bit of wiggle room. So another go. Started. Let's try this one. Once those two start, okay. Other side. Okay. idea for flat fingers. Right, that's that one started. That fitted. Not the prettiest of mudguards. It'll do the job. Could have possibly got the front a little bit lower, I don't know. It's in line with the leg anyway, so because these are measured, so yeah. I think there was a hole here somewhere for the, oh yeah, there. So we should better get the speedo cable mounted there. Whether I need something for the brake pipe or not. Might just need something to hold that off. Whether if I change these for different angle ones, which I was going to, and it comes more up this angle, I probably won't need anything then. Yeah, so that is another little bit done. I've got the side panels painted. I've just got to put the emblem on there. What else? A couple of wing mirrors, a couple of mirrors, and I think I've got a couple of bulbs out in the display. And once that is done, I've then got to get it registered. I'll get a Dayton certificate first and then get it registered. So hopefully that'll be ready for spring.